Welcome back. In this session, we will discuss how to ensure good conditions for composting by mixing. At the end of this session, you should be able to understand how to ensure good conditions for composting by mixing different materials, specifically, water content and carbon-nitrogen ratio. Understand how temperature and monitoring helps checking the process of composting. Let's start with water content, also called moisture. Composting proceeds best at a moisture content of 40 to 60% by weight. At lower moisture levels, microbial activity is limited. If you are blowing air through your compost system, you will need to be careful not to dry it out. If the temperature drops sooner than expected, and the compost looks dry, you may try mixing in some water and see if the temperature rises again. At higher levels of moisture, the process is likely to become anaerobic and foul-smelling. If your compost starts to smell bad, chances are it is too wet. Mixing in additional bulking agents such as dry wood chips, cardboard pieces, or newspaper strips is likely to alleviate the problem. There are different ways to monitor and control water content during the composting process, either using a moisture meter or by hand. When you squeeze a handful, a few drops of water should appear, then the moisture level is ideal. Now, what if you have different masses of materials with different water contents? How much final water content can you expect? This can be known by first calculating the water weight in each material, then summing this up and dividing it by the total wet weight of all materials. Besides water, microorganisms need carbon and nitrogen to survive. For each unit of nitrogen, they ideally need around 30 units of carbon. This is what we call the CN ratio, which for composting is ideally around 30 to 1. As carbon gets converted to CO2, the CN ratio decreases to a ratio of finished compost typically around 10 to 1. Here are some examples of CN ratios of different waste materials. As you can see, some materials are suitable. Other materials, however, do not have suitable CN ratio ranges. Make sure that you can nevertheless compost them by mixing with other waste material to obtain a suitable final CN ratio. Let's see how to do this. Like moisture, we can also calculate a resulting CN ratio when mixing different materials, each with their own CN ratio. For this, we need the wet weight of the material, the water content, and the CN ratio of that material. From there, we first calculate the dry weight of each material, and then the carbon weight for each material. We sum all material carbon weights and divide by the sum of all dry weights to obtain the final CN ratio. Here is how you can play with these two parameters when using an Excel file to conduct the calculations. In this Excel sheet, we have entered these formulas explained before. In this case, we have several waste materials with different moisture content and CN ratios. Now, let's say we have 1,000 kilograms of food waste and 500 kilograms of mixed grass. After entering that, the results show that the CN ration is too low for composting. Luckily, we also have some dry wheat straw. So, let's see what happens to the mixture if we add 500 kilograms of wheat straw. As you can see, the moisture drops and the CN ratio increases significantly, but too high for composting. So now let's reduce the amount of wheat straw to 300 kilograms. The moisture content is more or less okay, but the CN ratio is still too high. Now let's enter 100 kilograms. As you can see now, the moisture content and the CN ratio are suitable for composting. This shows how with different waste materials, and by mixing different amounts, you can create a good final mixture for composting. Now let's have a look at temperature. Heat is generated as a byproduct of microbial breakdown of organic material. Temperature is therefore one of the key indicators in composting. Measuring the temperature allows to gauge how well the system is working and how far it has progressed. To take your temperature readings, make sure to use a probe that reaches deep into the compost and take measures at different locations. By graphing compost temperature over time, you can tell how far along the decomposition has progressed. A well-constructed compost system will heat up rapidly up to 65 degrees within 2 to 3 days. Then, as decomposable organic matter becomes depleted, the temperature begins to drop, and the process slows considerably. If the temperature curve does not follow this trend over time, you can either check on your CN ratio and add other materials or your moisture content to see if this may be impeding the composting process. Then, either watering the compost or adding dry bulking material. This is it for a good composting process. Let's summarize what we have learned in this session. We have seen how moisture affects the composting process. If too wet, the compost pile will start smelling. If too dry, the composting process stops as the microorganisms cannot decompose the material. Different materials will have different water content, and we have learned how to calculate the water content of a mixture. Similarly, CN ratio has an ideal range for composting. We have seen how to steer the CN ratio by mixing different types of waste, and how to calculate the CN ratio of a mixture. Finally, we learned how temperature is an ideal monitoring parameter to gauge how well the system is working, and how far it has progressed. Thank you for listening. See you in the next session.